Morning, good evening, and welcome to Australia, where the more eagle-eyed viewers among you will have already noticed a big change to this year's show. Yes, one of the most gorgeous presenters on British television has been joined by Holly Willoughby. Hey, Holly's here, everybody.
Good morning, good night, and welcome to Australia on day two of Emperor Noel's reign. He came, he saw, he had a tiff with John Barrowman and sat on a damp cushion.
If he's not careful, he'll get a crinkly bottom. But whatever you think of him as emperor, one thing is for sure, the man is in great shape. Ah. Have you seen the guns on the arms in that toga? They look good. Every time I see him, I think, oh, I want to touch them, but I know that I shouldn't. It's a case of feel or no feel.
You do know you are live on the television, don't you?
I know exactly what I'm doing. Don't you worry about that. Good morning, good evening, welcome to Australia, where we begin with six words I've been waiting almost two decades to say. Noel Edmonds is in the jungle. Oh, boy. It was touch and go getting him in here, but in the end, we put a contract in front of him. Noel asked one important question.
Deal or no deal?
Actually, no. It was, are you allergic to kangaroo anus? But we should have asked him that. That would have been funny.
The main thing is, Noel is here, and he is the emperor, which means he's got power, influence, and above all, a toga from one of Australia's finest fancy dress shops.
It's a good toga.
He wears it well.
Coming up tonight, the celebs enter the Coliseum for a very special bush tucker trial. There's a dingo dollar challenge with a twist. Plus, and I really can't stress this enough, Noel Edmonds is in the jungle.
Yes!
It's not easy coming to Australia, meeting a whole load of new people. I've been coming here for 16 years. I've still never been invited out for a drink with the crew.
Yeah, they told me that.
When?
When the pub last night.
The pub?
Yeah, we arranged it on our WhatsApp group.
WhatsApp group?
Barney on camera four, he does the best impression of you. I'm a celebrity, get me over here! So funny!
I haven't got a high-pitched voice. Here's Noel. Settling into the camp.
Back to I'm a Celebrity, get me out of here. Before the break, we saw John, Emily, Malik and Rita, four actors getting ready to go head-to-head in the latest trial, Drown and Out.
Yeah, and like all thespians, before they could perform, they all had to get into the role. They had a question for me and Holly.
What's my motivation?
The answer, dinner. Now jog on and get in the tank. I've got a massage booked.
And I'm going to lunch with the camera boys.
You what?
The odds.
6-4. I'll just check the race and post. It's true. I could watch Harry all day. I really could. There is more grade A Harry coming up later in the show. But first, back to camp. And the moment the celebs found out, they were all heading to the bush, took a trial clearing.
Well, John had a good feeling about this. Rita had butterflies in her stomach.
And Harry had a fiver on Noel Edmonds turning up in a toga at 3-1. He's made an absolute killing there. Here's the moment they all got the good news.
Back to I'm a Celebrity. Get me out of here.
Just excuse me a minute, folks. What do you mean, nipply?
Well, it's just, it is a little. Hashtag Dex Nips is trending.
They've got a hashtag.
So happy. Before the break, we saw Emperor Noel Edmonds choose Harry as his personal advisor and nominate four celebs to take on the trial. First to impress the Emperor were Sarah and Fleur.
And this wasn't going to be easy. Neither of them had ever found themselves on national television trying to win the approval of a cruel, heartless tyrant who's convinced he can take over the world.
Wasn't Fleur on X Factor?
Sorry, yes, one of them hadn't. Here's Sarah and Fleur preparing to unleash the beast. Welcome back to I'm a Celebrity, get me out of here. We're on our way down to the camp to tell them who's doing the bush tucker trial.
Before that, back to last night's dinner when Emperor Noel and his inner circle would be eating and the rest of the camp wouldn't.
Basically, it was a case of, wait for it.
Meal or no meal.
I was saving that.
Hello!
Hello!
Good morning, good evening. Welcome to Australia on another busy day in the jungle where right now 10 celebrities are getting used to living in each other's pockets, spending every waking minute together.
It's not an easy thing to do.
Not
I mean, for
easy.
Start, you've got to get used to people's little habits, for instance, the way they obsess over their appearance, the irritating laugh.
Yes!
So
the irritating laugh.
But most annoyingly, the way people interrupt you sometimes.
Yeah, I'll take it from here, Holly. Shh, shh, shh. Coming up in tonight's show, Nick and Emily take a trip down memory lane in the Dingo Dollar Challenge, John takes the plunge in the latest trial, and Harry Redknapp reveals all about the time he went on safari in Africa.
He reversed his jeep over three zebras.
But first, back to yesterday morning, when the former snake rockers were waking up to a united camp.
And for the first time since they arrived in the jungle, they'd had a great night's sleep.
Which is important. Jeez. Important to get a good night's sleep when you're here. Personally, before I go to bed, I get a scented candle, an eye mask, and the romantic and sensual sounds of the Nick Knowles album.
He's number one, you know.
Good old Biffy Clyro.
A triumphant performance.
A fantastic performance. A performance which gave me another one of my great ideas,
did
Holly.
It?
What about this? Scary Rose, the musical, starring John Barrowman, huh?
Yeah.
What's that? Call, I shouldn't have this on during the show, but go with it. It's Lord Lloyd Webber.
No way.
It's Lord Lloyd Webber. Yep. John was excellent, wasn't he? What? You want him in the West End? 52 weeks a year, I'll tell him. Bye-bye. Well, what about that?
So Lord Lloyd Webber wants John to star in a musical in the West End?
No, he wants him to clean his aquarium. He's got a big aquarium in his flat in the West End. He just wants him to clean it. He thinks it'd be very good.
Well, he'd be
fabulous.
But to come now, and yesterday, James and Malik asked Harry about which football teams he'd manage.
And let me guess, Harry put his hands in his pockets and seamlessly turned the whole thing into a fascinating anecdote.
Yep, got it.
Welcome back, and the heavens have just opened.
Literally just this second. Oh, fabulous.
Wait.
Fabulous!
We're about to head into camp to make a big announcement.
But first, let's go back to last night, and after John got a full house in the trial, it wasn't long before 10 celebrities were enjoying the smell of a delicious meal cooking on an open fire.
Well, 9 celebrities, because Harry doesn't have a sense of smell.
That's very true. Is the night when
to become that is good. Whoa. Okay, stop the music, maybe.
You'll get bored before I do.
Really?
Hey, I tell you what. There is no Bush Tucker trial vote today, but we are heading down to the camp with some big news at the end of the show. The news is the Emperor's reign will soon be over and the celebs will all be watching Noel and Harry face in the next trial.
That's got to be worth an evil laugh.
Good idea. Good one.
Well, you know, it's tricky keeping up with your personal grooming regime in Australia.
It is, even for us.
Yes.
Even for us. I mean, we work long hours, so, you know, I'm so busy, I just do the absolute basics before work. I just have a quick shave, pedicure, manicure, facial, jacuzzi, deep tissue massage, backsack and crack. Smooth as an eel I am, and I'm ready to go live to the nation.
Oh, my God, the image in my head right now.
Describe it.
No, describe I don't want to think about it anymore. It's like a Bush Tucker trial.
All right, Joseph. Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah. Not
what, body roll now?
No,
do you
body
want a body roll?
Yeah.
Every year, doesn't it? They get their little fitness routines going, have a fitness class. And it is important, though, to keep fit when you're here in Australia. I've seen you've been doing a lot of weights since you got here, haven't you?
Yeah, I have. A lot of weights. I wait for you to get in the car every morning, then I wait for you to finish your breakfast, and then I have to wait while you spend ages getting ready for the show.
Hey, you can't rush a backsack and crack, you know that. You know that. Smooth as an eel. Smooth as an eel, folks.
Oh, my God.
So, Harry and Noel had won 7 stars up until now, but if they thought the trial had been disgusting so far, things were about to go to a whole new level.
This is all very stressful. I mean, how would you cope with something like that?
Well, if it was me, I'd stick this on. Noel Edmonds, Positively Tranquil. Soothing music for positive thoughts.
Wow. Is that real?
This is real.
When did he record that?
Well, I might be getting mixed up here, but I'm sure I heard he was on a rooftop bar in Soho and started jamming.
Let me guess, with good old Biffy Clyro.
Good old Biffy Clyro. But it does work, listen to this. It really relaxes you. Noel should try this. Put this on. Ooh. Okay, Noel, you're waiting in reception at the spa. Pop on your complimentary slippers and take a sip of cucumber water.
Ooh, and relax.
And relax.
Breathe deeply and feel all your troubles drifting away. Don't clear
your
mind.
Don't clear your mind. Then just stick 6 live witchetty grubs into your mouth.
Followed by 20 cockroaches.
And remember at all times, it's important not to vom.
When there's an eel in there.
Smooth as an eel.
Stop it! After the break, we saw the start of the first trial of the series, Viper Pit.
Facing this one was Emily Attack. But would the snakes attack? Would Emily be under attack? Would they say, as it were, attack, attack? Attack, attack, attack!
It's
attack, attack.
It's Emily Attack. It's not attack.
Attack, attack, attack.
No, no. It's Attack.
ATAC.
It's her name, ATAC.
ATAC?
Yeah.
Well, that's that knackered, isn't it?
Oh, my God, oh, my God, oh, my God.
Oh, my God, it just went by.
You're OK? Oh, my God, oh, my God, OK.
Well done, star number one. Get that straight in your bag, otherwise it won't count.
All right. Stern, that was stern.
It's all right.
That was stern, though.
It's my mum voice. John, you're storming this.
Well done, get it in the bag.
It's my life.
Back to camp now, where Malik and Fleur got onto one of their favourite subjects, rap music.
But you know what? I've never really got into rap.
It's get
not,
off.
Not my thing.
No way.
I don't even think I've met a rapper.
You have. You've met a number one rapper, pet. Yeah, you've been working with them for the last week.
Here we go.
Yeah, yeah. Let me tell you about us rappers. We're usually from the wrong side of the tracks, you know, running with the OGs, that's original gangsters. And our raps tend to reflect what life's like, you know, back in the hood.
Yeah.
I can show you my latest rhyme if you want. It's about the queue at the deli counter at Waitrose. It's getting ridiculous nowadays.
Go on, then.
What?
Go on.
Well, no, I can't actually do it at the moment.
Funny that.
Because I'm still working on it. I'm struggling to find a word to rhyme with hummus.
Back to the moment the two of us broke the news to Noel and Harry that the Empire was no more, and worse than that, they were going to face a bush tucker trial.
Ooh, when we told him, I think Noel had a bit of a flashback to Deal or No Deal, because I'm sure he called me a banker.
That's not what he called you.
Fabulous!